Hi, I'm Cale from Melling. Bearing clearances in an engine have a major impact on oil pressure. With this being said, accurate measurements are necessary to determine the correct pump for a given engine. Spending the time to properly measure the bearing clearances in an engine is a time-consuming process, but can be some of the best time spent building your engine. Given the variation in bearings and machining, I feel that every bearing and its adjoining journal should be measured for clearance. It may be necessary to use multiple sets of bearings or even different oversized or undersized half bearings to get the clearances where you want them. I like to start with a build sheet template to keep track of everything. This is also good information to have if you ever have a problem or want to sell the engine. Let's start with measuring the crank main journals. I like to measure each journal once and again at 90 degrees just to verify the journal is completely round. Once we have measured and documented the main journals, we can do the same for the rod journals. Now, let's move on to the rods. Start by installing the bearings into the rods. Using a rod vise, torque the rod bolts to spec. Now, using a dial bore gauge, measure the inside diameter of the rod and again at 90 degrees. Repeat this step with the rest of the rods, documenting the measurements with the adjoining crank journal. Now we will install the main bearings and torque the bearing caps to spec. If your engine has a main bearing cap mounted oil pump, you will also need to install it and torque the mounting bolt to spec. Now using our dial bore gauge, we can measure the main bearing bore diameters and document with the adjoining crank journal measurements. Now that we have all of the measurements, we can subtract the rod and main bore diameters from the crank journal diameters. This will give us our bearing clearances. If we have any clearances that are not within spec, we will need to determine why and address the issue either with oversized or undersized bearings or additional machining. Now that our bearing clearances are properly measured and set, we can assemble our rotating assembly. Once the crankshaft is installed, we can measure end play using a dial indicator. Now that we have determined the end play is within spec, we can install the piston and rod assemblies and measure the side clearance using a feeler gauge set. Next, after installing our new cam bearings, we can use a dial bore gauge to measure the cam bearing diameters. Then we can mic our cam journal once and then a second time at 90 degrees. Subtract the two measurements and we have our cam bearing clearances. The final oil clearance we will check in the block will be the lifter to lifter bore clearances. Start by measuring the lifter bore top and bottom and again at 90 degrees top and bottom. Mic all of the lifters, subtract the two measurements, and we have our lifter to lifter bore clearances. Now that we know our bearing clearances, we can determine which pump we need. We would use a standard volume pump for tighter clearances and a high volume pump for looser clearances. I'm Cale from Melling. Thanks for clicking.